can't believe that it's been a year since I decided to take the leap, go freelance and start working from home. And I want to share some of the tips and tricks that I have picked up along the way that have really helped me to keep on track, stay motivated and stay focused. And hopefully these will help you if you're in a similar situation to me. The first thing that you need to do is find what drives you, because that is going to be your motivation. Is it that you need to pay the bills? Is it that you want to save up for a fancy holiday continuously because you love having something to look forward to? Or is it the fact that you just really enjoy your work and you just want to dive into it? And to you, it doesn't feel like work, it feels more like a hobby. And you need to find that out first before you can really discover what it is that's motivating you, and you can harness that to get yourself going and make yourself excited about the start of every single work week. The second thing that I do every single day is I make sure that I get dressed and I get myself ready for work. Even though I'm just gonna be at home working from my computer, maybe no one's gonna see me except my husband, I still like to put on a full face of makeup and just kind of present myself well, the way that I would want to present myself to others. I feel that this really helps to get me in that working mindset and gets me going for the day. The third thing is to set yourself a schedule or a routine. So I tend to start work at about 6:30 in the morning, which sounds ridiculously early, but as a freelancer, I can kind of manage my own schedule. And I usually work until around about 6 o'clock at night. So I do almost a 12-hour day, but for me, that is what works. And I do really enjoy it. So I get up first thing, I will check my emails. I'll usually do a couple of small quick tasks before I have my shower. And then I'll do a little bit of housework in between waiting for my husband to get ready so that I can drop them off at the train station. Then when I'm back, I usually know that depending on the time, I've got certain tasks that I'll do over the course of the day. And this really helps me to break up my day so that I've got certain things that I know that I will do during certain times, but also it makes me, I guess, be aware of what it is that I've got coming over the course of the day as well. And I find that this really helps to set boundaries for me and make me be conscious and be present in what it is that I'm doing. I found it really useful to instill a lot of the habits that I had when I worked in corporate to working from home. And one of those things is keeping a list of everything that I need to do. What this does is it makes it very easy to see at a glance all the tasks that I need to complete that week, but also it keeps me motivated because I can go, okay, I need to do all of these things. These are jobs that I'm personally responsible for and I want to complete them by such and such a date. I can't express how important it is to take regular breaks across the course of the day, whether it's once an hour for 5 minutes or once every 2 hours, 15 minutes. That mental relief is just so valuable, and it's something that you do get very naturally in a corporate environment. But when you're home on your own, you really need to create circumstances where you can step away for a moment and just have a little bit of a breather. One thing I would recommend doing, depending on the structure of your day, is to try and spend a little bit of time outside, even if it's just 5, 10, or 15 minutes. I think it's really important to get that vitamin D. I quite often will take the dog for a run. I usually do this around 4 p.m. and I find that that's a way for me to get that air time outside, and I'm getting a little bit of exercise at the same time, and that really helps me to, I think, break up my day in a way. The next thing I would say to do is to create a work zone. So this is where you will work from home, whether it's a setup desk or it's at your dining table, but have a space in the house that you kind of associate with working. For me, I'm very fortunate to have a study room, so that is where I do the majority of my work. It's where my computer is set up, and I know that when I'm in that space, that is what I am doing. I think it can be really unhealthy to differentiate between working and relaxing if you are working in a space that you would usually relax in. So I don't really like to work on the couch, and I also don't really like to work in bed unless it is absolutely urgent and I'm working on something quite late at night. And that kind of goes on to my next point, which is to set boundaries. When you're working from home, it is so easy to just really overwork yourself and work all through the night. And I would say try and set some regular hours for yourself. So I know, based on what I said earlier, I'm probably not the best at doing this myself. However, I do try to instill into my working week periods where I'm leaving the house so that really I'm spending around about 8 hours a day just sitting at my desk. The last thing that you want is to feel like work is taking over your entire life. And I think that can be really easy when you let it creep into your relaxation time or your downtime. So what I would say is try and limit the amount of overtime that you do so that you can really enjoy your off time, especially because you're still going to be within that same space. This final tip might not work for everyone, but I wanted to mention it for those of you who it will help, is to have a change of scenery. I think when we are working within the same space, it can be a little bit easy to get a mental block. I mean, this happens anywhere where you're working there for a very long period of time. You kind of get stuck in the same patterns of thinking. So going and working somewhere different can really help to get those creative juices flowing and perhaps help you on your next project. I have occasionally gone and worked from a cafe, and I will set myself kind of boundaries in terms of how hard I need to work while I'm there, what I need to get done before I can leave, and I just really focus and buckle down while I'm out of the house. And I find that that just helps to, again, break things up, but it also adds a little bit of variation to my week and makes things a little bit more interesting. So those are my tips for how to stay productive when working from home. I hope that you found this helpful. If you've got any other tips or any questions that you would like to ask me, please leave them down in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching. I do hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you next time with a brand new video. See you soon. Bye.